You are born in North Korea.
Yeah, I was born in North Korea in 1995 in Pyongyang, the capital. And that's where I spent like the first few years before moving to Macau.
As long as anyone is alive right now in North Korea, that means they are not a threat to the throne. That's why I don't see that Kim Pyong-il to replace Kim Jong-un at all. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So today in this video, I will talk about who will replace Kim Jong-un. So as you have seen, Kim Jong-un has gained his weight, body weight dramatically after he came into power in 2011 after Kim Jong-il's death, the second game. So it is unbelievable like how North Korea is not able to control Kim Jong-un's health. There are more than 10,000 doctors dedicated to actually make Kim's live eternally. There's literally the place called Mansu Mugang Yeonguso. It's like a 10,000 years life research center for Kim's. That's how North Korea is using their resources to maintaining this dictator. However, the things they failed was keeping Kim Jong-un fit. When he actually came into power before, around 2009 or 10, when he was under the Kim Jong-il and trying to succeed, he wasn't that big of a guy. Actually, he was pretty slim and he looked quite healthy. But what we now know is that Kim Jong-un has a very bad temper and he has a lack of controlling himself with his temper or with eating. Therefore, when he gets angry, he does kill a lot of people just at the heat of the moment. And also, he does not even know how to stop himself while his health is really being endangered by being overweight. Kim family does not have a history of having a healthy body. So, it's fortunately at least they don't live that long, and second Kim, despite he had the best doctors, best resources, he didn't live that long. And I think Kim Jong-un is going that route as well, like his own father. So now we have to think about who can actually possibly replace him. Next video I will talk about then the possibility with the coup d'etat and other military officers, but today I will just talk about the Kim's family line. So Kim Jong-un is married to Lee Seol-soo officially in 2010, and supposedly the marriage was initiated by Kim Jong-un's aunt Kim Kyung-hee or his father Kim Jong-il himself. I mean, no matter who introduced, they got married officially, and some say they might have a son together in 2010. But then that actually son is even before Kim Jong-un had a son with his mistress Hyun Sung-ho in 2012, and that is very unknown. However, the very confirmed case of a child of Kim Jong-un with Lee Seol-soo is in 2013, the daughter that was born named Kim Joo-hye. That was confirmed by that Mr. Rodman who visited Kim Jong-un then, and he said he had a daughter of Kim Jong-un and had a good time with them. So we know that Kim Jong-un got one girl for sure. The other recently South Korean intelligence confirmed that in 2017, Kim Jong-un had another child with Lee Seol-soo, but the gender hasn't been confirmed. So there are three child that is unconfirmed gender, right? The one child with the mistress Hyun, that is, a lot of people say it's a boy, but we don't know. And the first child possibly in 2010 and 2007. So Kim Jong-un possibly have three boys, and or maybe not. They are all maybe happen to be girls, and North Korea is hiding the fact. The thing is though, what the daughter case, Kim Joo-hye case, was very open to public is North Korea is less secret about girls because they are not gonna succeed. And when it comes to boys, they are very more secret about it because they don't wanna people know who will be the next heir. Therefore, I think it's under the veil right now, we don't get to know. However, the next successor is not only coming from Kim Jong-un's children. there is another, in a way more traditionally looking at it from North Korean tradition, there's way more legitimate heir. That is the son of first Kim Jong-il's son, Kim Jong-nam, who was assassinated in Malaysia by Kim Jong-un's regime. Kim Jong-nam, the first son of Kim Jong-il, who was a potential heir until 2001. He went to Japan with a fake passport to go to Disney World or Land, and he got caught, and it was a huge embarrassment that North Korea's next successor was going to Japan to just have fun. Kim Jong-il got very upset and removed him from the next heir position and made Kim Jong-un the third son from his actual mistress to be the next successor. However, the Kim Jong-nam has a legitimate power because he is a first son from Kim Jong-il. And his son, Kim Jong-nam's son, Kim Han-sol, who is alive right now, and actually Kim Han-sol is in America. He's in the CIA custody.
Kim Han-sol, the half-nephew of North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, was reportedly taken into CIA custody after his father was assassinated in February 2017.
He actually has a more legitimate line than Kim Jong-un's children. Kim Han-sol, who was born in 1995, and right now he's 25 years old, only like 2 years older, younger than me. He's pretty young. However, his record shows quite refreshing. I still remember seeing Kim Han-sol on the interview many years ago.
You were born in North Korea?
Yeah, I was born in North Korea in 1995 in Pyongyang, the capital. And that's where I spent the first few years before moving to Macau.
He was still in his teenage years and talking about his family, which is Kim family, Kim dictators. He said that he never met Kim Jong-il, even though Kim Han-sol was born in Pyongyang. Somehow he didn't get to meet his grandfather, which was Kim Jong-il. And he was always raised abroad and went to school in France, later other countries. He's really educated globally. And he even denounced his uncle Kim Jong-un, I think his half-uncle Kim Jong-un, as a dictator, and his grandfather Kim Jong-il as a dictator.
Hi, my name's Kim Han-sol, from North Korea, part of the Kim family. Here's my passport. My father has been killed a few days ago. I'm currently with my mother and my sister, and we're very grateful to... And we hope this gets better soon, yeah.
Even though that was before the assassination of his own father, I actually thought that was quite brave of him to do that. He could have just simply chose to stay silent and not to comment and reserve his life, but in the public coming out as the potential heir of North Korean kingdom, he still made that brave statement. This doesn't mean that I think Kim Han-sol has any chance to replace Kim Jong-un or should. In a way, that for me is, I think North Korean people are done with Kim's, at least a certain family. But that doesn't mean though, it's forgiveness is impossible. As long as even till this point, Kim Jong-un choose to open up North Korea and doing things, the right things for North Korean people. I personally have every intention to support it and forgive the past. And Kim Han-sol the same way, that if he has a right and the right motive to replace uncle and do something right for North Korean people, my full support for him. I think the replacement of Kim Jong-un is very uncertain because the children are very young. The Kim Jong-un children are very young, and he has a uncle, I think Kim Jong-il, the second Kim, had a younger brother, Kim Pyong-il, who was an ambassador to one of the European countries, now back in North Korea. But the thing is, the fact that Kim Jong-un hasn't killed him is that it shows that he's not a threat to the throne. As long as anyone is alive right now in North Korea, that means they are not a threat to the throne. That's why I don't see that Kim Pyong-il to replace Kim Jong-un at all. I just hope that, you know, North Korean people gain the power and they can decide their own future. But we still cannot like eliminate the possibility that another Kim gonna come up. When Kim Jong-un came into power in 2011, everybody said that, oh, North Korea is going to collapse under the leadership of 25 years old. Can you imagine that, like, 25 years old managed to maintain this hellish prison camp for everyone? And I think like that media was wrong and the Western experts wrong. So I think if North Korea going into another succession to the fourth Kim, I think that's pretty plausible too, unfortunately. And it's like we need to look out too. However, the most important thing is like we gotta like make sure that the next Kim is not gonna replace Kim Jong-un, and we can be just done talking about Kims, right? I'm so sick of talking about this family, so cruel and fair, just greedy with power. I just hope that just can we be just done with these crazy guys and let's move on. So I hope that helped you to understand the current status with Kim Jong-un's his children and who might be in the line for the succession. And I will let you update more if anything new news comes up. However, just check out Kim Hansol. I think he's pretty cool. It is really refreshing to see from the elite of North Korea has that kind of perspective. I used to be a fan of Kim Jong-nam, the first son of Kim Jong-il, that who was kind of reformer. He always believed that North Korea had to open up and make things better for the people. And, you know, so that's the thing, like, I don't hold against that, like North Korean regime does, because his family committed a certain crime, that person has to be punished, you know, collectively. That collective guilt is something not my thing, and anyone is up for redemption and they can make a difference. Thank you guys for watching, and if you really like what I do, please go to my Patreon, become my Patreon and support me there. Otherwise, I will see you all next time here. Bye!